Hey guys, this is Jim D from Pure Jeevan, and I'm here in Portland with Bibi McGill.
What's up, Jim D?
Thanks. And let me quick introduce Bibi in case you might know her already. Bibi is the lead guitarist and musical director for Beyonce. She is a raw kale chip manufacturer extraordinaire. There's some of the product right there, Bibi's Kale Chips.
Yeah, Bibi made Kale
with,
Chips,
made
BKC.
With love. BKC. And also a certified yoga instructor. I forgot to mention that. Sorry for not mentioning that. The first thing I want to ask, since it's a raw food blog that we run,
okay,
is how'd you get into raw foods? Like, tell me about that.
Well, I lived in LA about 9-10 years ago, and they were doing this 21-day raw food detox. So a friend invited me to go, and we did this raw food detox for 21 days, and when it was done, not only was the food delicious, but when it was over, I felt light, I felt clear, you know, and I was already a healthy eater. So that was really the beginning of me starting to incorporate more raw foods into my diet. So over the last 10 years, I've, you know, pretty much brought myself from, at times I was 100%, and that was really cool because I felt like I was depriving myself, and sometimes I needed warm food. So now I'm at about 70% raw and 30% I eat whatever I want.
Now, when you say whatever, do you eat, like, do you ever eat junk food, like sweets and all kinds of stuff?
Absolutely.
Yeah?
I mean, honestly, I don't have a sweet tooth, and I'm not really into, like, donuts and cakes and stuff like that. But when I say whatever I want, I might go and buy a bag of, you know, jalapeno potato chips or salt and vinegar potato chips, or I love pork ribs. So if I want to eat some pork ribs, I'm going to eat pork ribs.
I saw, you're big on pork ribs, aren't you?
I always got to say I'm eating pork ribs.
You know, there's nutritional arguments about that too, about having a healthy amount of cholesterol and things like that. I mean, but you don't sound like you're not really concerned, or are you concerned with all that stuff?
No, I'm really not concerned. I'm fortunate enough to have very, very good, strong health. I'm more concerned with just mentally and emotionally not depriving myself, and you know, also just being a real person, not trying to fit under, you know, a label that says, oh, I'm 100% vegan raw.
Right.
You know,
right.
Whatever. I don't care. If you told me that you're vegan raw, I'll be like, yeah, look at my pork ribs.
And yet, most of the time, you kind of are. You kind of do eat like that.
What, just vegan raw?
By default.
Most of the time I do, and I love it, you know, but I want to stray. It's all good.
When people get tuned into the importance of food and diet and nutrition, seems like kind of a natural direction that people start becoming interested in the source of the food, like for lots of different reasons. And I was wondering what your relationship history with growing your own food and gardening and that kind of interest, what's that like?
Well, you know, to be honest with you, I moved to Portland in 2007, and one of my goals was to own a home that had a yard so I could have a garden. So at that time, I was on the internet researching everything about gardening. No one taught me. I learned it on the internet. I built my own raised garden beds and started growing my own food. My first year, my garden was just, people were stopping going, oh my God, you've got an amazing garden. Wow. It was my first one. You know, I had kale, collard greens, squash, all the herbs, blueberries, strawberries, everything you can imagine. And that was my beginning of learning how to grow my own food and eat it. And there's a lot of joy in that, you know, going out to your garden, grabbing hold of a tomato, eating that, grabbing some garlic, eating that, grabbing some lettuce, eating that.
So, there's nothing better, right from the
vine.
And
you know where it came from.
Absolutely. You know, a lot of people get into not just raw foods, but also yoga, which are two areas that you're interested in, for reasons of longevity. And I was wondering if you have any ideas on that subject. I mean, is this one of your motivations, or do you think about that kind of thing?
Well, I don't really think about longevity as much as I think about now and being present.
Uh-huh.
And the reason I started doing yoga, what got me hooked on it, was the same thing that got me hooked on raw food. I felt better. I felt light. I felt clear. And I felt more balanced, and I need a lot of balance, because even when I'm really balanced, I'm still crazy.
Yeah.
So, you know, yoga brought that to my life, and so has raw food. So the combination of them both is just, you know, double-edged sword.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And you need some pork ribs to balance you out on the other.
Absolutely. Okay, that's right. Okay.
You know, my wife and I have often talked of starting a community in the future, and I read that you kind of alluded to that too, and I just wanted to find out about this vision of yours and why it's important to you.
Well, not as much a community as it is, if you can imagine, an eco-village or an eco-empire that's like a Edgefield. You know Edgefield?
No.
Edgefield? You don't know Edgefield?
Okay. I'm new here.
Okay, it's all right. The type of community I want to create is really a place where I can process my BB kale chips.
Okay.
But I also want to have the opportunity to grow my own kale, because I'm really picky about my kale, and I know that you have to pick it at a certain time for it to have the best flavor and the most nutrients. So that's important to me. I'd also like to have this community or eco-village have a wellness center where people can come for alternative forms of healing, yoga, massage, Reiki, crystals, singing bowls, different things like that. People who can gather who are like-minded in their spiritual beliefs and their beliefs of how they can take care of their bodies. And I'd also like to, you know, Portland's really big on food carts.
Yeah,
so I'd like for it to, you know, also have a couple of people bring their food carts in and set it up. You know, people can come in and we can have some animals and kids can come and pet the animals. We can have music there, DJs, and just, you know, have people come together, eat healthy, enjoy art, music, and have a good time. But if you know what Edgefield is, and if you know who the McMenamin brothers are, mini eco green version, sustainable of what they're doing.
Take us through how you got not just into eating kale chips, but how you decided to take this on to the whole next level and make a whole company devoted to kale chips.
Okay, well, this is what happened. You know, I had my first garden. I was growing purple kale and kale in my garden. At the end of the season, I had all this kale and I couldn't eat it by myself, so I was like, okay, well, I know people make kale chips and I have a dehydrator, so let's get some of this kale and make some kale chips. So I found a recipe, didn't like it, saw another recipe, didn't like it, so I created my own. And I tweaked and added what I liked, which is spice and salt. So I dehydrated them for 20 hours, it was my first batch. I couldn't wait to eat them, got up in the morning, opened it up, this is the first chip, and was like, oh my God, I can't believe I made that, this is amazing. So I started sharing them with my friends, and my friends had the same reaction, like, oh my God, I can't believe, how did you do this? This is delicious. And they would share with their friends and their coworkers, and everybody was all of a sudden like, where are those chips? Where are those chips? They're amazing, I'm addicted. So I thought, people really like this. It was November at the time, and I said, by January 2011, I'm going to have these on the shelves in Portland. And I went, I found a commercial kitchen, I got the dehydrators, I hooked up with the suppliers for all my produce, and I got my food license, and January 2011, they were in the stores.
So can people order these online from anywhere right now?
Yes, you can order these online at www.bibikalechips.com. That's bibikalechips.com. Or you can also get them here in Portland at four of the co-ops, Alberta Co-op, People's Co-op, Food Fight Co-op, and Food Front Co-op on Thurman.
Okay, yeah, I got them at the People's Co-op.
So
I
live okay.
Not far from
cool.
there. So you're going to replace the potato chip?
I'm going to replace the potato chip, absolutely.
But you still eat them sometimes.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Salt, vinegar, potato chips.
Yes, definitely. right now, are you just focusing on kale, or you think in the future you might have other products?
Right now, I'm just focusing on kale. I'm actually in the process of developing three new flavors. It's going to take a while to tweak them because they have to taste at least good as these. So.
Now, do you, since you have a lot of kale, do you green smoothies and stuff like that? Or?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Yeah? You're into that?
Smoothies with collard greens, Swiss chard, spinach, green apple, green lime, you know.
Nice.
Throw a banana in there, some blueberries or something. Just mix it up.
You know, you're on tour with a major act, you know, world tours, and imagine you're not just forgetting about. You don't just eat McDonald's all the time. I mean, do you lug a Vitamix along with your Les Paul? Or, I mean, what do you do?
No, I don't, although I thought I would do that on the next tour for sure.
Oh, yeah?
Okay. Yeah, I mean, on the road, generally, we stay in nice hotels, so hotels are usually willing to make juice for me. I'm really the only one that has a special diet on the road. But, you know, I've asked hotels to make me some juice with spinach and celery and whatever.
So now we're in Gallery Zero. The guy let us in, so don't tell anybody. This is, so you were talking about how the hotels would make you juice and stuff sometimes.
Yeah, on the road, hotels are usually pretty open to, you know, doing special orders for us, making juice for me or a special salad, whatever. And also, I mean, where there's a will, there's a way. I've been to Bolivia, I've been to Chile, I've been to Uruguay, I've been all over the world, and I've never, ever not been able to find a vegetarian or a vegan restaurant,
wow,
ever. So.
That last country I never heard of. I
mean, Uruguay.
Oh, Uruguay. Oh, I heard of that one.
Uruguay, Paraguay. Yeah.
I forgot that other people don't always speak English
in
the world. I'm interested if you've ever noticed any correlation between your guitar work and your lifestyle, meaning yoga and raw foods or diet consciousness. Like, if you just started eating junk, I mean, would your actual performance and your mental clarity that is required for that be affected?
I think so. I mean, doing yoga helps to bring an inner awareness, and it keeps you connected to that flow, to that energy. And eating good food also does the same thing. It keeps you light and clear. And by doing so, when I'm on stage, it just allows a more clear channel and more open channel for me to let that energy come through and send it out there to the audience and give them what they need, give them that energy. And we play off of each other. Now I give them energy, they give me energy. Give them
right
back, and it's pretty cool.
I mean, well, Bibi's the guitarist for Beyonce.
No.
Yeah? See, do people believe you when you say that?
Not in Portland, they don't care, which is why I live here. If that was LA, it'd be like I'm eating, oh my god, you're the guitar player for Beyonce! Not in Portland.
I'm not live, don't worry. But it's going on the internet. The dragon is right on top of your head. This is so cool. Come and talk to her. She said, well, if she loves it, she should put a ring on it. She started making all these.